Buongiorno, this is my last day in Italy. I am joined by this beautiful chemist slash formulator, Deborah.
Hi guys, how are you?
I know a lot of you guys asked me how to become a chemist or how to become a cosmetics formulator. So I think she would be the perfect person to answer this question. First of all, what do you do?
I lead R&D for a cosmetics and skincare company and work a lot on formulations and understanding, you know, what are the products that we want to launch for the coming year. So product creation, formulation, also setup and marketing story.
She looks really, really young, but she has a lot of experience. How many years of experience do you have?
Over a decade at this point.
Holy moly. You know what works? Your skincare routine.
my skincare routine.
Tell me about your education.
So I majored in material science and engineering at MIT, and then I went off to get my PhD and master's at Cornell University, also
That's
in material
a joint.
Science.
So you studied material science. How did you develop this interest towards this beauty industry? Or even like just formulation in general.
Definitely. So here's the thing, right? Material science is such a broad field. You can go anywhere. You can go into, there's ties to biology, to chemistry, electrical engineering, physics. Something that really appealed to me was the interaction of materials with the body, with the skin. Really, like, that appeal to me was, how can we use materials to just improve quality of life for anything? And cosmetics was like such a great interface for that because you have such a direct connection to the consumer. And for me, it was really important that you're making things for the consumer. At the end of the day, it's going to be on someone's face. It's going to be on their skin. It needs to be a good experience. You want it to work and it has to feel good.
First job you had was in L'Oreal?
It was at L'Oreal. I joined as a senior chemist.
Yeah.
And worked on active cosmetics. You know, it was a fantastic company to work for. They have like a lot of resources, so it was a really great training ground to understand how to develop cosmetics, how to formulate, how to, you know, understand the materials that go into a lot of things, and also the testing components. So it was a fantastic experience. I loved it. So you have your basic hydrations, but then you say, you know, what are those things that can help you with preventative skincare?
Right.
And so I worked a lot in that as well.
What happened next?
I went off to a small company. Some of you guys might have heard it, called Elf Cosmetics.
That's not small at all.
And then, you know, that was also a great experience as well because you really dove into like color cosmetics.
Right.
Basically, you know, figuring out, hey, what do we want to launch? What do we want to create?
So when you were doing like product development, coming up with new product, what were the factors that you counted in order to have like, okay, let's make this?
Couple of things that we look at is, what is the need? Is there like a solution that we're trying to provide for the consumers?
Yeah.
What does she want? What does he want? What does it make sense to do? Can it feel good? Can it like look good? And then we think about your costs. At the end of the day, guys, pricing is still, it's unfortunately still a piece of this to take into account. Can we make it at a price that people can afford?
Especially with e.l.f., I bet.
Especially with e.l.f. The whole premise behind it is we tried to make luxurious beauty available for all.
True.
So that price point is pretty low, but at the same time, we're not trying to sacrifice any of the quality for what it is.
Yeah, my subscribers ask if expensive formula or expensive brands make better formulation.
You know, I get this question relatively often. So there are products where, you know, it works really, really well and you don't have to like, you know, it doesn't cost you an arm and a leg. But there are products that are at a higher price range that are a bit more efficacious, you know, because the ingredients, these ingredients that can impact your skin, they're expensive. So, you know, there is some validity to it, but the same that you don't need like the extremely pricey things to get a very good effect as well. So I would say combination, it depends on the formula, it depends on the product.
That's like the trickiest thing. How do one know if a formula is like created really beautifully?
You know, I look at a couple of things, right? So what does it look like by itself? If we're looking at skincare, say like an emulsion, you know, lotions or creams, does it look very smooth? Does it look very shiny? That's one type. But, you know, if it has like a different effect, you know, does it have like that right texture? You don't see anything separating out. You don't see a little bit of oil sitting on top. That's like one thing just to know, hey, is it done well? And then also what's in the formula? Because there's different ingredients that, you know, I'm sure that as people are looking at the ingredients is that are occlusive, you know, they cover the skin. They might keep things from going into the skin. And then there's other things that are you know, too watery, maybe they evaporate too fast.
Mm.
If that happens, you know, you also don't get the effects on your skin too.
Right. After e.l.f., what are you doing now?
I always think about consumers first when we create a product.
Mm-hmm.
And I really like purpose-driven brands.
Mm-hmm.
So I've worked on a project called Better Not Younger. And it's a hair care company which is looking at hair changes for women once they've reached 40 in their 50s.
Right.
Because one of the things is, you know, not only does your skin change with age, also your hair can change as well.
For sure.
And that's like an entire area that, you know, really hasn't been getting enough attention.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they are a consumer that also has concerns too.
Right.
Just launched it and I'm very excited about that.
Yeah. Better Not Younger.
Better Not Younger.
Yeah. I'm super excited about the launch. What would you say is the most important thing for anyone who dreams about to become a cosmetic chemist or someone like you?
To have a passion for your consumer, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know your ingredients, but also know what works for them, what they're seeking. And this is like the one place where you're creating a product that people can experience immediately.
Yeah.
So know your consumer, respect the consumer, mm-hmm. know your science, know your formulas, know your ingredients.
I do work with a lot of formulators and mm-hmm. I do come across a lot of these really, I guess, exhausted formulators who's been in the industry for way too long. And they kind of lost that spark, I guess. So, yeah, and not really treating all the projects too seriously anymore.
I think it's always good when you find your partners where you want them to be excited and be involved. It's not just, you know what, I have somebody coming, I'll just make whatever, because it's going to be the same as the other thing. But that's really not how you want to look at it. I think, you know, I do think when I make a creative formula, they're all my babies.
Yeah.
Like, ugly babies, you guys don't get to see. Mm-hmm. The beautiful babies, you guys get to see.
Yeah. What's one formulation or one formula or one product that you wish you invented?
Oh my God. I really, really wish that the SkinCeuticals C Ferulic would have been something I thought of. The technology behind that's amazing, guys. One of the reasons why I really respect the creators of that product is they took a lot of time to understand the efficacy levels and stability levels. And the thing is about vitamin C, once it's exposed to water, once you have overexposure to air, it oxidizes and your efficacy levels drop. So I think just having that amount of knowledge and science to, you know, create something like this,
mm-hmm.
it's incredible. And mm-hmm. to be honest, I think they've paved the way to let other brands think about developing products like that.
So you want to support that.
Mm-hmm.
Why do you do what you do?
Why do I do what I do? Interaction with the consumer. Because here's a secret, guys. When a new product launches that I've been involved in, I read all your reviews.
Wow.
The reason why I read it isn't so, you know, give myself a pat on the back. A lot of times it's to understand, well, what is that experience like for you?
Yeah.
Right? So if I get a chance to talk to people face to face, I do it.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you know, I'm looking at, hey, how are people talking about it? Is it a good experience? Is it working? Is it not working? I want to know.
Yeah.
Because then, you know, that comes, you know, back to being a formulator. We think about making it better. Think about those reiterations.
Yeah. Have you taken like negative feedback too?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I mean, and you know, those are useful too, right?
Yeah.
Because it tells me that, you know what, we could have done better.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, something happened in the middle that mm-hmm. it's not what I thought it would be.
Mm-hmm.
So I do think it's very useful to have. Like, we hope you guys aren't too harsh about it, of course.
But a constructive criticism.
But it's very constructive. Like, we take it as constructive.
Right. Awesome. One last thing that you want to say?
Formulations, it's not as sexy as it could be, I suppose, but it's a really fun, like, you know, thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
Because you have, like, creativity. You get to talk with a lot of, like, the ideas, inspiration, and creation, which mm-hmm. I really like.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you're interested, I definitely encourage you guys to look into it. Try things, like, you know different textures, no different brands. What do they do? What are they known for? And it's really exciting, guys.
I think it's a very exciting job. And thank you so much, Deborah, again, for being on the show. And I'm off to the airport, and then she's off to Milano. Please support her by supporting Better Not Younger. Thank you so much.
Bye.